London. Our featured game comes from Pool B. It's South Africa against New Zealand. Two teams who've made very different starts to their campaign at the 2012 Olympics. New Zealand won their opening match 1-0 against neighbours and rivals Australia. It was their first ever Olympic Games win against Australia. For South Africa, it was a very different story. They went down 7-1 to Argentina. But having said that, they are the lowest ranked team here, 12th out of 12 countries. New Zealand in the white are 6th. Here come the two teams. New Zealand, nicknamed the Black Sticks, are in the white strip today. They're versatile and quick and looking to improve on their showing in Beijing when they finished last, but buoyed on by the fact they won bronze at the 2011 Champions Trophy. However, this year they finished just 6th in that competition. New Zealand have the world's best young player in Stacey Michelson, and their real pace comes from Anita Punt, who will wear number 32. South Africa failed to win a group game in Beijing 4 years ago and are keen not to repeat that record. And there's a star, Piti Kotzia, who's come back from international retirement. Kef Taylor, born in Oxford in the United Kingdom. Sulette Damons, a left winger. He's only been in the national team a couple of years. Posing leader. She'll be the ball stop from penalties. The striker. Another striker. Centre half. Central defender. Centre half. Baby of the team, 16. Now 16 years old, made her international debut, still only 23. And here's the real pace of the team, Anita Punt. Rather grey, overcast morning in London. We've had problems on the underground system as well. People have been late taking their seats. And now the national anthems of the two countries. So New Zealand, the overwhelming favourites to win this Pool B tie against South Africa, who are led by Marsha Marisha, number 8. But watch out for Damons. Only been in the national team a couple of years, but making a name for herself. Remember, there's rolling substitutions throughout the game. The leader on the pitch for New Zealand, number 1, Kayla Sharland, who really runs the show in her third Olympics now. She missed the 3 international matches against Korea in February 2011 after straining a quad muscle while lifting weights in the gym. She really is that dedicated. As we've already said, Anita Punt will provide the pace for New Zealand. But New Zealand riding the crest of a wave after their Olympic Games victory against Australia, and they are red-hot favourites here to win against South Africa. They have an excellent defence. Quick check on the 2 umpires. 35 minutes each way then. It's South Africa who get this Pool B match underway against New Zealand in their chain strip of white. Free hit. Important for South Africa not to concede early on here. This is Punt. Stick infringement. Punt allowed to move the ball forward and into the danger area. Well, early infringement. Came off somebody's leg. Indeed, it was a mistake there by Leslie Ann George, striking her foot, hence the penalty corner in the opening few seconds, and not the start really that South Africa would have wanted. So 5 defenders allowed back here for South Africa as they try to defend it. 31 is Stacey Mitchelson, who's going to inject the ball. Opening goal, terrific start, and it's the leader on the pitch who scores the opening goal. Oh, cleverly worked. Everyone expected the shot to be goalwards, but it was a clever piece of play. And Harrison on target. Lottie Harrison. South Africa nil, New Zealand 1 on the scorer, Charlotte Harrison. So just about the perfect start for New Zealand with that early goal. Good to see ya. Once again, New Zealand just trying to break out of the their own half. Stick infringement quickly taken. Kath Taylor, I think she's got the long corner. That just relieves the pressure. Here's the goal once again. That wasn't a wayward shot, it was something cleverly worked by New Zealand. Neither team have got into their stride yet, and that's why it's so impressive that New Zealand have taken this early advantage. 29 is Taryn Bright into the D. Hit somebody's foot. Has to go to the dotted line. Nobody can make a challenge after, unless the ball has travelled 5 metres. Nita Punt back on defensive duty. Back to the dotted line again. Good defence by New Zealand. Look how many white-shirted players are behind the ball. That's their strength. They scored early on against Australia. Charles Bonnet, the head coach of South Africa, must be worried about the early goal his team have conceded. Katie Glynn marked in midfield. Glynn. Now, where's she going? Stick infringement by Glynn. Powerfully built midfield player. Remember, South Africa trying to put behind them that disappointment of losing their opening game 7-1 to Argentina. Kath Taylor losing out, and it's picked up easily by Sam Charlton. Oh, that's a dreadful mistake. Glynn, she really should have made it 2-0. Leslie Ann George, who gave away the penalty corner from which New Zealand scored, almost gave possession to Glynn. Well, she did, and it almost caused a second punt. Hop, skip and a jump on her way towards goal. Ball won back by Eshuis. Sideline put in for South Africa. Picked up by Sharland, who was very much involved in that New Zealand goal. And here goes Anita Punt once again. Chased hard though. Shelley Russell with a foul. Free kick to New Zealand, or free hit to New Zealand rather. Gunson. Punt, changing the axis of the attack. Once again, Shirley Russell gives away the foul. Long corner then. All the pressure being brought to bear on the South Africa goal. Punt. Struck a South Africa defender, and I think it was Leslie Ann George. Indeed it was. It's a penalty corner once again to New Zealand. They really have taken this game by the scruff of its neck and look very capable of recording a second victory here. Five defenders, including the goalkeeper, trying to keep this one out. umpire not happy about something. Only four defenders now. There must have been an infringement on the line. Here comes the injection. Ball is in, but I think the referee had spotted something there before Sharlan had the shot on target. That is not going to count. The South Africa counter-attack. Long corner. No, it's a sideline put in here for South Africa. Up towards Dirkie Chamberlain, number 12. Scored South Africa's only goal so far here at the London Olympics. Says her aim is to play in Brazil in 4 years' time. Good intervention. Sharlan getting it wide. Gunson, the right back. Chamberlain with a foul, free hit. To be taken by Ella Gunson, student. A mistake by New Zealand, Essius. Long corner which Shelley Russell will take. Ilsa Davids. Wilson unable to control the ball with a stick. New Zealand have an Australian at the helm, Mark Hager. Very successful hockey player for his country. Gunson. That's a delightful flick. Punt calling for it. Doesn't come her way though. They're queuing up in the middle. Samantha Harrison wanted the cutback from Finlayson, but it never came. Harrison still lurking with intent inside the D. Beresha. Free hit now to South Africa, who've conceded an early goal. Beresha. Davids into the back four. Foul by Russell, or was it? South Africa on the front foot now. Russell looking for a little bit of support, ran into a little bit of traffic. Did well to win the free hit. New Zealand very, very strong defensively. Stick infringement there by Maresha. Free hit on the edge of the dotted line. Taken by Eshuis, the right-hander, who made her international debut 7 years ago. Just a bit too hard for Anita Punt. Much more of an even contest now. One or two pre-match nerves displayed by South Africa, which they've shrugged aside. But they have to try and make an impact on this game now, and they're not going to do it like that. Had one or two downpours already this morning, so the playing surface is inevitably going to be quick. Punt. Picks out Glynn. There was an infringement. So Glyn's power opens the door for New Zealand once again. Time to kit up then for South Africa. It's their third penalty corner conceded. Harrison to inject. Another infringement. Must have struck a foot. Hence another penalty corner, which Samantha Harrison will inject again. Pant looks like the stopper here. Sets it up for Strickland. Sharland, rather. That's well won back by New Zealand, but they have conceded the free hit. Davids. Unless you're looking for an opening, that there just wasn't one. Glyn won it back. Pretty close to a second goal for Kayla Sharland, who really is the on-team leader for New Zealand, who are back defending now. As Hughes, in a bit of a mess, but eventually got the ball away to Punt, who can really run with stick and ball. Here she goes again. This is her stock in trade. And she's won the free hit inside the 23. Michelson. Great chance here. Bit of a scramble. Another penalty corner then to New Zealand, and they're racking these up now. This is just the amount of pressure they're putting on the South Africa defence. It struck somebody's foot at some stage, and I suspect it was Murray's foot, which was the problem there for the umpire. And it's time to kit up again for the South Africa defence. Try stop New Zealand claiming a second goal. Emily Naylor looks like the stopper. Right flip and left flip available. Mitchelson, the injector. Good save by the goalkeeper to deny Eshuis. Rick's doing her stuff. Shot by Glyn, beaten away. Shelley Russell. Charlton. Charlton again, came off the South African player, hence the free hit now for New Zealand, and they push plenty of women forward into the last third, inside the 23-metre line. That's good stick play. Sharland, oh, she had her legs taken away. Sharland on the 23, and he can only score from inside the D. shooting from outside the D. He's just trying to win a penalty corner, hoping to hit the foot of one of your opponents. Flynn. Last penalty corner, superbly saved by Mariette Ricks. Has been suffering from lower back pain throughout her career. Still no sign of a South Africa response yet. New Zealand looking for another goal. Glynn, given back dangerously towards Naylor. Emily Naylor at her third Olympic Games. Kutsia. Put in here for New Zealand. Sun just beginning to peep out. Cooper on the pitch now. Hardly see much of her. Here is Cooper. Plenty of options here for New Zealand. Woods doing your best to defend that difficult situation. Mitchelson. Another penalty corner then. New Zealand women work out their tactics. They'll have several different plays at penalty corners. Stacey Mitchelson to take it. She's going to inject the ball here. South Africa have done well to repel most of these. But not this time. It's 2-0. Clarissa Essus, the right-hander, firing in goal number two for New Zealand, and they have a deserved two-goal advantage. Great accuracy. Stopper doing a job, and that low strike good enough to beat Ricks. Closest South Africa have come. Wrong side of the goal. Jennifer Wilson shooting close, but not close enough. Confirmation of the goal scorer, Essus. Sideline put in here for New Zealand. We've made a very bright start to this Pool B game. Pool includes Argentina, the USA, Germany, and Australia. Aerial ball. Reverse shot on goal. Not a bad one either. Good effort by Samantha Harrison, who's already scored once in this game. Long corner. Crystal Fulgerson, student. Russell back on defensive duties for South Africa, who managed to work the ball clear, but they haven't cleared the 23, but they do have a free hit. Russell. And Russell's won it back here for South Africa. Can she drive to the D now? She can. Good goalkeeping there. Bianca Russell to the rescue. Wilson went flat out trying to win the ball, but not quite. And here come New Zealand on the counter-attack. Kayla Sharland into the D. Glynn is there. Picked up, though, by Davids. Video appeal. Presumed for an infringement. There was an alleged push.
Did you hear me? Oh, okay, thank you. New Zealand is asking if there's a South African foot for a penalty corner.
Let's see if there was a foot there. It seemed to take a couple of ricochets. Glynn was pretty insistent. She was the closest to the action. Just wait for the video referee's decision here. The South African women are already geared up for the penalty corner.
Penalty corner.
And it is a penalty corner.
Wait, is no. Hold on. I didn't give a penalty corner, so there's no reason to change my decision. So it's a free. Okay. Thank you.
So penalty corner it is. Both teams, I think, already knew that prior to that lengthy discussion between umpire and video referee. Here's the injection. Sharland, what's a really good effort on goal and a really good save. Mariette Ricks in the action again. Sharland. New Zealand recycled play again here. Gunson. Ball just knocked in by Ferguson, which almost resulted in another goal. It was reminiscent of the opening goal of the game, scored by Harrison. Same move, didn't come off that time, and that one doesn't come off either. Punt unable to get in the game. Decision goes away of South Africa. Maresha, 29 is bright, and she's quick. And it's a good ball into the D and hooked on dangerously there by Kutsia. Her first real chance on goal. Good diversion of the ball, and it's New Zealand on the counter-attack. Here goes punt again. Good change of direction by punt. Kutsia almost halving the deficit. Almost, but not quite. Bright. Gives it away to Glynn. Glynn to number 12 here. Ellie Gunson. Gunson about to come off. Remember, as many substitutions as you want in hockey. Glynn is a player who takes a break. Free hit to South Africa now for that infringement. Normally when a ball strikes the body of an opponent, most of these free hits are for that. Long corner. Leslie Ann George at the sharp end of the attack now. Leslie Ann George wants it back, and she has the ball on her stick. Stick offence. Leslie Ann George again. Leslie Ann George plans on retiring from hockey after the Olympic Games. Shelley Russell wins a free hit. She really is tricky, but she's lost the ball now. Well, that's brilliantly done. Look at this run by Punt. Barged off the ball. Almost results in another goal for New Zealand. Shot is by Finlayson. It was Punt's acceleration which South Africa found very difficult to defend against. Harrison again. It's a great ball, Finlayson. And a great goal by Charlotte. What a lovely move by New Zealand. Kayla Charlotte playing at her third Olympic Games. And there might be an appeal here. So it can't be Charlene's goal because it was outside the D. But was it touched in just in front of the goalkeeper?
Saying that New Zealand did not touch the ball inside the circle.
Charlene claims the goal, but the ball quite clearly left her stick outside the D, and I think South Africa have a very strong appeal here. Ooh, it was very close indeed, wasn't it? Virtually on the line when she hit it. No, it was outside the D, looking at that replay. I don't think that goal's going to stand. Unless there was a touch on the ball. But taking their time, rocking the videotape back and forward. Nobody touched it in front of the goalkeeper, that's for sure, looking at that slow motion replay.
I know it was outside. We're checking to make sure it wasn't touched inside, okay? No problem.
Finlayson was the player closest to the ball as it flew inside the D.
Making sure there's no touch inside the circle.
It's taking quite a while to sort out. It's two issues. Pretty certain now the ball was struck outside the D.
And they keep the referral, thank you. Right, but come here, there's no advice possible, which means they cannot tell. So the goal is stands, however...
Then you got to win me my question. My first question was it was not touched by Kimmison in the circle. That was the question.
And that's the question I relayed back, okay? I said that there was no touch. No, but you keep your referral. I want to make sure that you understand that you get to keep your referral, okay?
They're not happy, the South African team. That goal's going to stand. The referee, or the umpire rather, could not get any advice from upstairs. But they keep their referral, which is a kind of compromise. It is 3-0. That goal does stand. Interesting to see if the goal is credited to Sharland or Finlayson, who seemed to get the closest to the ball. The official statistics say Sharland, who scored the third New Zealand goal. Real sense of injustice now in the South African team. Slightly soured the match, because that goal could be crucial really in ending any hopes South Africa have of getting back into the match. Still plenty of time left, mind you. Russell. Curtsy. Curtsy unable to win it back, and here come New Zealand again. Lovely stick work there. Glenn goes chasing the ball. Harrison unlucky not to claim another goal. Two captains told to cool things by the umpire. Brief appearance by the sun here at the London Olympic Park. Doesn't mean much of that today so far. Jesus holding things together at the back. A long, hopeful ball forward, though, intercepted back by South Africa. But a turnover of possession and almost through to the onrushing Harrison. Lottie Harrison, beauty therapist. Younger sister also plays hockey. So the first half just beginning to draw to a close now, with New Zealand comfortably in control. The question now is if they're going to try and do much more in terms of scoring in the remainder of the game, or just play a tight defensive match and frustrate South Africa. Sharland with a free hit. Aerial ball by her. We'll go over the sideline. Really positive burst there by Ferguson. Stick infringement. Free hit once again to New Zealand. Sharland's going to take it. Score of a third goal, despite all the protests. That was outside the box. Did get a deflection, I think, from Glynn, but repelled. Murray. Glynn waiting in the middle. Last couple of minutes now, this first half. Damons, look at her pace. Reverse pass into the D. Dealt with very effectively though by Eshoos. First time really we've seen Damons really get to grips with the ball. Punt wins it back. And it's fed once again by Sharlan, and it's punt now. Punt. Yanesia. It's a great ball into the middle. Mitchelson was there. Those hopeful balls into the D, ideally looking to strike the foot of an opponent. There was a foul, I think, by Damons. Hence the free hit to New Zealand. Shortly now, the crowd will count down the last few seconds, but maybe New Zealand have a fourth goal in them. Flynn. There's a hooter for half time and a comprehensive 35 minute display by New Zealand, rattling in three goals. Glynn has been a real handful for the South African defence in that period. But Harrison, Eshoos and Sharland have all scored for New Zealand. At half-time, it's South Africa 0, New Zealand 3. So confirmation of the goal scorers for New Zealand, Harrison, Eshoos and Sharland. And that early goal by Harrison really settled the nerves. They scored within 3 minutes against Australia in their last match, the New Zealand team, and they've managed to make a very, very comfortable start again here against South Africa. They are overwhelming favourites to win this hockey game, but just because you're favourites doesn't mean to say necessarily things will go all your own way. Women's hockey was introduced at the Moscow 1980 Olympic Games. None of these six participants who took part in that inaugural competition have ever returned to competitive hockey at the Games. Here are the highlights then of the first half opening goal. Really good skill here by Harrison on her knees. And that deflected shot, absolutely perfect. I'm sure they've been working on that in training. And the high fives from Sharland, who played the ball so accurately into her. Glenn almost had the chance to double the advantage. Shot just wide. Plenty of controversy, plenty of penalty corners for New Zealand. Flynn trying to get the ball back in towards Glenn, but there was an infringement. Sharlan went to ground. Another penalty corner then to New Zealand. And a second goal filled in by Eshuis. Then a disputed goal, a really disputed goal. Was Sharlan shot inside or outside the D? It has to be inside, remember, to count. South Africa captain Marsha Maresha claimed otherwise.
The Olympic flame, spectators and crowds, world records.
Confirmation then of the statistics of that opening half.
Medals, brilliant. Mind you, it would be brilliant if we were the Olympic Village. That's never going to happen. This is Hayden. Nothing happens here. Be good if it did, though.
Day two at Hayden Olympic Village. Following yesterday's dramatic events, the scene was set for some truly exciting Olympic action here today. The conditions were perfect for the first contest of the day, the 50-meter garden hop. Meanwhile, in the Peking Chuck, Rob Rod setting a personal best.
Still one or two grey clouds overhead. Have been problems on London Transport today. One or two youngsters rubbing sleep from their eyes. The hockey arena here, one of the furthest points from the entrance to the Olympic Park. So it's about a 40-minute walk from the local station. Four more hockey games here today. After this one, Belgium against China, then Great Britain against Korea, Argentina against the USA, and Germany against Australia. One day the men, next day the women. London 2012, first time world event to be played on different coloured synthetic turf from the traditional green. There's a 15,000 capacity Riverbank Arena boasting this distinctive blue and pink pitches. And the idea is it should provide better contrast with the yellow ball. Young and old enjoying the hockey. Though this is the main pitch here. There are two pitches. This one stages all 76 matches, while the other pitch next door is used for training by the 380 competitors in 24 men's and women's teams. After the games, the hockey centre will move to a 3,000-seater facility north of the park that can be extended to 15,000 for major events. Crowd completely exposed to the elements here. Indeed, our broadcast positions too are not covered. That's the Dutch team taking in the hockey. Game consisting of two 35-minute periods, a 10-minute interval at half-time. Some finding it all just a little bit too much.
Hi, I'm Seb Coe. I'm chair of the organising committee. I'd just like to welcome you to this great hockey venue. If it's the first time you've been at hockey, then please join a local club, get your kids involved. It's a great school. And if you're regulars, then you know exactly how good this is. And enjoy the games. It's a great pleasure to have you here with us today.
So South Africa reappear for the second period. There's Leanne George, just about ready. At the interval then, New Zealand leads South Africa by 3-0 in this Pool B match of the women's hockey at the Olympic Games. New Zealand in the white strip and looking to add to their impressive 3-goal haul in the second half. So New Zealand get the second half underway, ranked 6th in the world. They qualified for London 2012 after winning their third consecutive Oceania Cup in October of last year. Actually, their qualification was in fact a formality, as only two teams enter the tournament. And Oceania had been allocated two places in London. But they've done well here. They won their opening game against Australia. Feat they've never managed in previous Olympic Games, and they've made a very bright start to this particular match against South Africa. They have the sideline put in. Murray. Final ball has been very disappointing, and the turnovers have been very much in New Zealand's favour. Good see it. Helped on that time by Leslie and George, but picked up pretty easily there by Ferguson, the student. Good see it. Lovely turn. Beaten away, shot was on target. That's more like it by the most recognisable of South Africa's hockey team. And then she made a rather elementary mistake. Hit that one just about perfectly. Sadly for Kutsia, it was straight at the goalkeeper, Bianca Russell. Had a fine game against Australia in New Zealand's opening match. Ball struck the body of Emily Naylor. Kurtzia. Mitchelson wins the free hit, and off she goes again. Then feeds Finlayson. Finlayson might need some help. Finlayson almost went out for the long corner. Malaysia will flick ball looking for Shelley Russell. Punt. Look how easily New Zealand are able to change the axis of their attacks here. There's no space down their right, they switch it to left. And the accuracy of their passing is the key to that. Ferguson. Ooh, punt almost got there. No, it's not going to count. Finlayson is disappointed here. Shot was from outside the box by some way. Malaysia. Punt. Look at her go here. Into the D. Straight at the goalkeeper. Needed to angle a shot either side of Ricks there. Just couldn't do so. Shelley Russell. Puts her head down. That was the great players play with their heads up. Know exactly where the ball is. Charlton back on defensive duty. Another sideline hit here for South Africa. Sharland. See ya. Who got the final touch? The answer is Sharland. This is Punt's shot on goal. Remember, the goalkeeper, the only player in the team who can hack the ball away with their feet. Even if the ball inadvertently strikes the foot of your opponent, it's a free hit or a penalty corner if it's inside the D. Sharland now. New Zealand's hockey really has been free-flowing. Not on that occasion, no. Flynn invited to chase the ball. Shelley Russell didn't see the arrival there of Punt. She really is that quick. Long corner now to New Zealand. Here's Punt. Well won back. Foul by Punt, surely. Murray. Russell. There's certainly a sense of frustration on the South African bench. That's hardly surprising. They haven't made inroads into this 3-0 deficit. Although here goes Bright. Taryn Bright. Played in 2008 at the Olympic Games in Beijing. Kutsia. She has now the sort of influence that the South African Women's Hockey Association would have wanted. Has been one of the stellar players in the world in the time, but just unable to influence this game at the moment. There's a fine ball drilled into Leslie and George, but couldn't get a decisive touch on the ball with a stick. Charland. Surrounded by South African players, and she's lost the ball as well. Is this the moment for South Africa? Colston. Colston drags it back, looking for Damons, who's on. And the shot is just wide. Probably South Africa's best attack of the game. I think it's Kutsia who had the shot. Long corner. Free hit from the dotted line. Oh, that's going to be a foul. No. South Africa had the advantage. Harrison. Change of direction, unsuccessful. Chamberlain, able to keep the ball alive. Kutsia, was really good shot on goal, but it was also a very good save by Bianca Russell, the business systems developer. Kutsia maybe getting her range now. She's had a couple of shots on target in this second half. If you've just joined us, this is the Women's Hockey Tournament from London 2012. South Africa against New Zealand. New Zealand in the white and in possession here. 3 goals to the good. Having a very good opening to their competition. Punt. Essus. Drill the ball wide with it, just a little bit too much force. Oh, ball given away dangerously. Rather hurried shot in the end by Harrison. Oh, the ball given away again to New Zealand inside, just outside the 23. Dangerous play by South Africa. Inquest going on at the back. Gunson dispossessed. Good turnover there. 22 here is Taylor. Taylor again. Stick infringement. Taylor went to ground. Go back to the dotted line. Nobody in a white shirt can touch a ball. Unless it's travelled 5 metres. Shot was well outside the D, but nobody touched it. I was talking to a colleague just prior to this game, and he said to me, watch out for New Zealand taking a commanding lead and then sitting back. And he's absolutely right. That's exactly what's happened. Kurtsey trying to win it here. It's still Kurtsey for South Africa, and it comes off the shin of the goalkeeper. Pienka Russell. Kurtsey's had 3 attempts on goal in this second half now, yet to get on the score sheet. Damons. Twenty-one is Murray. Cooper. Free hit to New Zealand. They want to get on with it quickly with Flynn. Woods trying to hold things together at the back for South Africa. Kurtsio walloping that ball across, looking for a colleague or either a New Zealand foot. Neither happened. Kurtsia. Well, that's a neat layoff by Kurtsia to pick out the captain, Maresia. Maresia trying to initiate this attack. Wilson goes to ground. And we have our first penalty corner of the match for South Africa. Was there a push? Certainly seemed that way from number 16, Essus. Taylor Sharlin just trying to get some clarification from the umpire.
She tripped before she was pushed.
Yeah, and I don't think
traffic and it was an obstruction.
Okay. So you're asking for the trip before the push?
Yeah.
Okay.
So video umpire required.
New Zealand is saying that the South African tripped before there was a push. No, New Zealand is asking that there was the push was after the trip. Okay.
That looks a pretty clear penalty corner to me. Taylor Shannon thinks otherwise. Seemed to be a push there by Jesus.
Penalty stroke. Thank you. They lose a referral, yes?
So the appeal is rejected, and it's going to be a penalty stroke.
From 7 metres.
Great chance here for South Africa then. Good see ya. And she's on target. She had three previous shots saved. Could see her on a landmark appearance then. I wonder if South Africa will be enthused and feel they can get something from this match now. Another goal would certainly make things interesting. Maybe the game isn't done and dusted yet for New Zealand. Katie Glynn is on for New Zealand and in possession here. Charland. Good save again by Ricks. Harrison with a really good effort there. And another opportunity. Penalty corner awarded to New Zealand. Infringement, I think, was from Woods. Stick tackle on Flynn, and that is not allowed. First goal of the tournament so far for Pete Kutsia. Umpire wants South Africa in position quickly in this penalty corner underway. Emily Naylor looks like the stopper here, number two. Indeed she is. Ball's still loose. And another penalty corner. Must have struck a South African player. Well, it certainly struck one there. Well, this is frankly academic because it clearly struck the South African player on the line.
What are you
white foot.
Yeah. It's a white foot.
Yeah.
So, like, what, we want to know what the corner's for.
So what they're saying is that the New Zealand player touched the ball first before it struck a South African player, and if that's the case, so there shouldn't be a penalty corner.
Elena, you get that? Yeah. The white foot first. Okay, thank you. Just tell me.
It certainly struck a white foot there. Finlayson. Question is the order of events. So the referral is rejected by the umpire. It is a penalty corner to New Zealand and a chance now to extend their lead in this game. Emily Naylor again will be the stopper here. Will be a right flip and a left flip either side of her. And a shooter. Into the shooter. Again, well saved by the goalkeeper. And this time New Zealand unable to convert another penalty corner. Goodness, they've had their chances in this game. Best opportunity came to Ferguson, but she couldn't take it. The ball whipped so quickly towards her. This is Gemma Flynn, centre half. Almost won back by Harrison. Charlin. One of the most impressive aspects of New Zealand's game is their defence. That's really what they're relying on, and probably will rely on now for the last 13 and a half minutes of this match. Costin. Great run by Costin, and just unable to pick out a teammate in the middle. She's from Johannesburg. Studied chiropractic. She might need a bit after that tumble. Here is Wilson. Bit of a chase on for Chamberlain. And Chamberlain with a cross. Mitchelson. Change of direction. George. Good to see you. Could see it. Just kept alive there by Sharland, who scored the third goal of the match, a disputed one for New Zealand. Game has got a bit scrappy in the last few minutes, as we had for the last 10 minutes of the match. Blanche, haven't seen much of her so far. Stick foul. Apologies from Catherine Finlayson, the woman who scored the winning goal against Australia. Really, that should be a green card, or possibly even yellow. Green card, 2 minute exclusion. Yellow card, 5. Red card, permanent exclusion. Katie Glynn forced wider and wider, but has the sideline hit now. Woods. Captain dispossessed. Oh, that's a brilliant goal. And that should put the game to bed. Kayla Sharland with a second of the match. Again, shooting right from the edge of the D, just as she did for her first goal. New Zealand's first goal of the second half. Two goals almost identical. Long corner. Free hit goes South Africa's way. They take it quickly. That goal will be really important for New Zealand. It just gives them that breathing space, three-goal cushion, to see them towards their second victory in Pool B. Couple of days' time, they play Argentina, the second seeds in the competition. That's going to be their toughest game, surely. Followed by a meeting with the USA 2 days later. Finish with a game against Germany. Pretty bright start by the Black Sticks. Worth bearing in mind, New Zealand failed to win a match at the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing, losing all five group matches. When they lost to South Africa, a repeat of today's game, in the 11th place playoff. Oh dear, that was right into the cheek there of Katie Glynn, one of the youngsters of the group. She certainly felt that. Here she is again. Kate Woods. Married now. Brother Benjamin also played first class cricket in South Africa. Of smiles on the faces of the New Zealand women. They know now inside the final 5 minutes that barring a major miracle, they're going to take another step towards possible qualification for the semi-finals, but there's plenty to do for them. Chamberlain trying to slalom away towards goal, not quite successful. Leslie and George. Peculiar aerial ball straight into touch. And that'll put pressure back on New Zealand. One back there by Sharland. Really important tackle. And here's Sharland again. Surrounded by green shirt. She draws the foul. Free hit to New Zealand. Anita Punt waiting to come back on. Stacey Mitchelson, voted the world's best young player, 2011. That's unbelievable skills, isn't it? She's doing it again here. Taking the ball to the corner to waste time, and she can do it too. The skill here in doing that is quite extraordinary. I wonder how many hours training it takes to be able to control the ball with a stick like that. Home supporters don't like it because they know she is more than capable of running down the clock and wasting plenty of time. Bit of gamesmanship. Green card. 2 minute exclusion here. Catherine Finlayson is the woman shown the green card. And she won't figure again with only 1:38 on the clock. So she's played her part in this victory for New Zealand. Mitchelson, here she goes again. A useful weapon to have, not particularly attractive in terms of wasting time, but she has managed to ensure that South Africa don't have possession. Whistle's gone, free hit now to South Africa as we move inside the last 60 seconds of this match. Anywhere will do. Ball hacked inside the 23. And shortly now the crowd will count down the end of this match. Kutsia. I think that's it, bar the shouting. Victory belongs to New Zealand. It's two wins out of two. Arguably their easiest game of the pool, but they're easy when you win them. And they follow up their marvellous win against Australia with a comfortable victory against South Africa. Sterner challenges to come against Argentina and USA and Germany, but the final score here from Pool B, South Africa 1, New Zealand 4. Confirmation then of the goal scorers. Charlin scoring twice for New Zealand. Harrison and Eshoos also on target. Kutsia pulling one back for South Africa on her 250th appearance for the country. Remember, she announced her international retirement and came back for these Olympic Games. A well-earned breather. And a day off too for these New Zealand women, for they're back in action again. Here are the goals. Harrison diverting the ball in. Accurate shot from Eshoos to make it 2-0. Controversial third. Was it inside or outside the D? Kutsia with a splendid penalty goal. That made it 3-1 in New Zealand's favour, but the scoring wasn't over yet. Charland on target again to make it 4-1. So two wins out of two for New Zealand. They're well and truly on their way. The Black Sticks are on form. Goodbye.